हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. हाउ आर यू? होप यू आर ऑल फिट एंड फाइन एंड सेफ इन योर होम. माई सेल्फ गुलशन शरीफ, योर इंग्लिश टीचर, वेलकम्स यू टू महिला समाजा ऑनलाइन डिजिटल क्लासेस. सब्जेक्ट इंग्लिश, टॉपिक द बॉय विथ अ मिशन, क्लास सिक्स स्टैंडर्ड. Dear children, in our last class we studied about a small boy, that is Iqbal Masiha, how he struggled in his life and finally he was assassinated by the enemies. So he was at the age of 12, he was assassinated when he was 4 years old. He was sold to the carpet factory to pay back his parents' debt. Okay, so now we'll go for the next part of the story. So the Craig Kelberger was a social well-known activist and motivational speaker who came forward to set the children free who are doing the child labor. So let's go for the next part. He took the story with him to school and shared what he had learned with his class. When he mentioned the idea of starting a children's group to fight child labor, 11 students raised their hands, calling themselves 12 years old. The dozen of them started by doing small things, writing letters, distributing pamphlets, signing petitions, faxing world leaders, speaking at church gatherings and community events, and mobilizing the school students. Their agenda was very simple: to raise awareness about the existence of child labor, to encourage other children to get involved in the issue, and to generate a strong opinion against the practice. So he took many he took Iqbal's story and he compared with himself, and he found number of differences. His life was full of fun while he was enjoying in his life. In the same way, other side, Iqbal was struggling in his life. He felt very bad, and he took this story as an example, and he started influencing other children to involve in the studies. So Craig went to school and started sharing things what he had learned when he told them his idea of starting an organization belonging to the small children. He just other students, they came forward and they raised their hands. 11 students, they raised their hands and called themselves 12 years old. These dozens of children started off by doing small things like writing letters, distributing the pamphlets, and signing the petitions, giving speech at the churches and community events, and so on. This idea was very simple: to create the awareness about the child labor. Things started to snowball. What began as a small effort by a dozen young children started gaining strength, with more students volunteering to work for the cause. People and establishments began to take note. Craig began receiving invitations to speak at larger gatherings. So here snowballs means to grow rapidly in size. ಮೊದಲು ಒಂದು ಚಿಕ್ಕದಾಗಿರುತ್ತೆ, ಇಬ್ಬರು ಸೇರ್ಕೊಳ್ತಾರೆ, ಆಮೇಲೆ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಜನ ಸೇರ್ಕೊಳ್ತಾರೆ. ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಎಸ್ ದ ಸ್ನೋಬಾಲ್. ಇಂಟೆನ್ಸಿಟಿ ಆರ್ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಗಿವನ್ ಬೈ ಆಲ್. ಸೊ ದ ಒಪಿನಿಯನ್ಸ್ ವರ್ ಶೇರ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ಅದರ್ ಪೀಪಲ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಈವನ್ ದೇ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟೆಡ್ ಟು ಗ್ರೋ ಬಿಗ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಬಿಗ್. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ವಾಟ್ ಬಿಗ್ಯಾನ್ ವಿತ್ ಎ ವೀಕ್ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಜಸ್ಟ್ 12 ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ನೌ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ ಎ ಸ್ಟ್ರಾಂಗರ್ ವಿತ್ ಮೆನಿ ವಾಲಂಟಿಯರ್ ವರ್ಕಿಂಗ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕಾಸ್. ಪೀಪಲ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಆರ್ಗನೈಸೇಷನ್ ಬಿಗ್ಯಾನ್ ಟು ಮೀಟ್ ಕ್ರೇಗ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೇ ಬಿ ವರ್ಕ್ ಹಾರ್ಡ್ ಟು ಫಾರ್ ದ ಅಪ್ಲಿಫ್ಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ಆರ್ಗನೈಸೇಷನ್. At a congregation of delegates on the Ontario Federation of Labor in Toronto, Craig told the 2,000 odd audience, according to the International Labor Organization, there are more than 250 million working children. That's equal to the entire population of the United States. No one has a good excuse for ignoring this problem. His speech had such an impact on the audience that he received $150,000 as donation for the cause that evening. Though he had gone there only to raise awareness about the issue of the child labor. So when this Craig went to a meeting with the delegates of the Ontario Federation of Labor in Toronto, Craig told in front of 12,000 people, according to the International Labor Organization, there are more than 250 million children were there who are working. It's equal to the entire population and the United States. Those who are working hard for this organization, no one had an excuse or ignoring this problem or telling that this is a waste. All they come forward, and his speech was so powerful that the audience gave. He had gone there only to raise the awareness, but in return he got $150,000 as donation to improve the organization. In 1995, Craig traveled to Asia to see what else he could do to tackle the issue of child labor. As Craig was only 12 years old, it was difficult for him to convince his parents to let him go. But they finally did agree. Craig traveled with a human rights activist friend for 7 weeks through Bangladesh, India, Pakistan, Thailand, and Nepal. He journeyed through sweatshops in back alleys. Seeing firsthand the working conditions of child laborers, memories of that trip constantly reminded him about the indomitable spirit of poor and working children. Realizing that poverty and lack of education were responsible for the menace of bonded labor, he owed to mobilize funds to rehabilitate and educate children freed from bondage. He and his brother Mark co-founded Free the Children, an international charity. So what do you mean by sweet shops? In the sense means factories or workshops that overwork and underpay workers. They extract the work more and the payment was very low. That is called the sweet shops. And back alleys means narrow passages behind or between the buildings. So here in 1995, the Craig traveled to Asia to see the awareness and he could do for child labor. So what he was shocked, he was only 12 years old. It was very difficult to convince his parents to let him go, but they agreed the last. So no parents was interested to send the 12-year boy to create the awareness around, but he convinced his parents and let him go. Craig traveled with a human rights activist for 7 weeks through Bangladesh, India, Pakistan, Thailand, and Nepal. And finally, he enjoyed his journey, factories, workshops, and narrow lanes behind the buildings, seeing by his own eyes the condition of child labor. The children were in very miserable condition. By seeing this, he passed the narrow buildings and narrow lanes which were between the buildings. As one of its very first project, Free the Children galvanized youth across the Canada to fund Bal Ashram, a child rescue center set up by the Indian child activist Kailash Sharma Satyarthi. Craig was highly influenced by the 2014 Nobel Peace Prize co-winner. He says that Free the Children was born out of a promise made to Satyarthi to share his legacy. During his visit to India, he had witnessed Satyarthi kicking down doors and giving the gift of freedom to hundreds of laboring children in India. When Satyarthi was imprisoned for his actions, Craig and his volunteers back home collected 3,000 signatures and wrote a letter to the Prime Minister of India asking for his release. The petition and the letter were sent to India in a shoebox wrapped in brown paper. 1 year later, when he was released, Satyarthi described Craig's petition one of the most powerful and memorable actions ever taken on his behalf. So, as one of the important projects, the Youths of Canada raised funds for Bal Ashram, a child rescue center set up in India by Kailash Sharma Satyarthi. Craig was highly influenced by 2014 Nobel Prize winner. He says that Free the Children was soon out of a promise made by Satyarthi, because when he met Craig, he had visited India. When he visited India, he saw Kailash Satyarthi fighting to poor children and was arrested when Craig went back, and his volunteer collected 3,000 signatures and wrote a petition to the people of India requesting to set the Satyarthi free. And this petition letter was kept in the shoebox, dropped in a brown paper. 1 year later, when he was released, he described that Craig's petition was one of the most powerful and strongest action taken by from his side. So, who is Kailash Satyarthi? Kailash Satyarthi is an Indian social reformer who campaigned against the child labor in India and advocated the universal right to education. He was born on 11th January 1954 and spouse was Sumedha. He got the awards Nobel Peace Prize, Robert F. Kennedy Human Rights Award and many more. Education, Barkatullah University Institute of Technology. Children, Bhuvan Ribu and Asmita Satyarthi. Every action, however small, counts. Since its inception, Free the Children was built more than 650 schools and school rooms in developing countries, providing education to more than 55,000 children every day. The charity is run by children to empower children. According to Craig, one of the missions of Free the Children is to create a world where all young people are free to achieve their fullest potential. So here potential means capacity or ability. Free the Children has two main purposes: to free children from poverty, exploitation and abuse, to give children a voice, leadership training and opportunities to take action on issues which affect them from a local to an international level. So every action you do, the even though small country sites, its birth, Free the Children built 650 schools and school rooms in various developing countries. Education to more than 55,000 children every day. This charity is seen by children to encourage children. According to Craig, this organization has the full potential to change the world. So here, there are more than 23 million youth involved in this initiative wonder of the organization, most of the whom are under 18 and inspired by the slogan Free the Children from Poverty, Free the Children from Exploitation and Free the Children from the Notion They Are Powerless to Effect Change, from national level to international level. Free children from poverty, free children from exploitation, free children from the notion that they are powerless to effect change. This slogan sparked off Craig's passion and continued to fuel the organization. He was like a magician who had influenced children to change their destiny to their dream. It comes true into reality. Every day the movement grew, and every day more number of people joined the organization. Craig, now in his 30s, continued to fuel the organization. Many years ago, while reading Iqbal's story, he had learned that the bravery and the intensive voice can be hidden in a small body. This proved that both in his accomplishment and through the empowerment, he can do anything and he can achieve everything. Free the Children is dedicated to eliminating the exploitation of the children around the world by encouraging youth to volunteer in, as well as to create programs and activities and that relieve the plight of the underprivileged children. See Craig, a story. He was shocked this by Iqbal's Masiha story. So that the rights to children's rights to read, children have the basic human rights to read, children have the right to access text in print and digital format, children have the right to choose what they read, children have the right to read text that might mirror their experiences and languages, provide windows into the lives of others and open doors into our diverse world. Children have the right to read for pleasure. Children have the right to supportive reading environment with knowledgeable literacy partners. Children have the right to share what they learn through reading by collaborating with others locally and globally. Children have the right to benefit from the financial and material resources of government agencies and organizations that support reading and reading instruction. So he also wrote a prayer for the children. You can read the poem silently in your home. See, human rights. Child is meant to learn, not to slave. Child rights, right to education. Right under UNCRC, the right to be heard, the right has to be childhood, the right to be educated, the right to be treated fairly, the right to be right to the healthy. Children's rights and business of UNICEF or UNICEF organization, protection of children, human rights in India. Education, children rights. So children, what are the rights? Proper education, fresh food and water is their right, safe environment, proper health, play. Yes, labor, play yes, labor no, safe and decent shelter. Laws on the child's rights and protection, children's right and responsibility, Child Fund Japan, so home assignment, who was Kailash Satyarthi, list out few children's right, when was Craig born, glossary, profound means great, hazardous, dangerous, plight means unfortunate situation. Children, I hope you understood the lesson. What are the struggles that Craig Kelberger and Kailash Satyarthi has suffered a lot to abolish the child labor and set the children free. So now we'll go for the grammar section. In grammar section, you have intransitive verb and transitive verb. What do you mean by intransitive verb? Means a verb that does not need a direct object to complete its meaning. Example, run, sleep, travel, wander, and die are all intransitive verb. So what do you mean by transitive verb? Intransitive verbs, for example, intransitive verb has two characteristics. First, it is an action verb expressing doable activity, like arrive, go, lies, sneeze, sit, die, etc. Second, unlike a transitive verb, it will not have a direct object receiving the action. Here are example of intransitive verbs. See, intransitive verb and transitive verbs, you can see the difference here. Intransitive verbs are either followed by a word or a phrase, and such words or phrases typically answer the question how. Intransitive verb does not require a direct object to express a complete thought. For example, she smiles, he cries. When you come back to transitive verb, a transitive verb exerts its action on a direct object to express a complete thought. A direct object is a recipient of the action and it can be either a word or a phrase. These objects answer the question what. For example, I saw a lion in action many years ago. Transitive verbs and intransitive verb need an object. In transitive verb case, intransitive verbs cannot have an object. For example, I bought a car. You buy something that is an object. What you bought? A car. Car is an object. What did you buy? A car. So car is another object. So here transitive verbs need an object. if you go for intransitive verb, you cannot have an object after an intransitive verb. You cannot smile something. We waited, but nobody came. So waited is an intransitive verb here. Came is an intransitive verb. So transitive verb and intransitive verb. Transitive verbs are action verbs that have an object to receive that action. More examples you can see here. I bake some cookies. I ride the bicycle. I move the chair. So bake, ride, move. These are the verbs there. Intransitive verbs are the action verbs that, unlike transitive verbs, they do not have an object receiving the action. I laugh. I cry. The book falls. See, you can see the more words here. If you want, you can use this exercise, this worksheet as an exercise, and you can upload me in the WhatsApp group here. I hope you understood this grammar and lesson. Meet you in the next class with a new chapter, with a new topic. Till then, stay home, stay safe, have a good day. Thank you.